Hi, I'm Betty. Welcome to Betty's Kitchen. Today we're making succotash, and I'm making that in response to a request from a lot of you who are on your new diet from your New Year's resolution, and you want to eat a lot of vegetables, and you don't want to have a lot of fat in it or a lot of sugar in it. So succotash seems to be something that would be very nice. I'm taking my regular recipe and I'm adapting it a bit in order to cut down on fat. And I'll tell you the changes that you can make if you want to make the regular recipe. Succotash is mainly known as a combination of lima beans and sweet corn, whole kernel corn. And it originated in New England, but it's kind of migrated southward, and we consider it a southern food as well now. Sometimes it's made with green beans and whole kernel corn, but that you see less often. What we need to do is find some kind of lima bean. These are baby lima beans that are frozen, and some type of whole kernel corn. This is golden sweet corn that is frozen. If you would rather use the canned varieties, that's okay. Those aren't as tasty and they aren't as colorful, and I don't think you will be as happy with them, but if you have them in your pantry and you want to just check out the taste of it, then that's an easy way to do it. But what I'm going to do is cook these two first, and then we'll continue with our succotash recipe. This one, the lima beans, has to be cooked longer. I'll have to cook this for about 25 to 30 minutes, or maybe more like 20 to 25. I'll be watching because these are baby limas. They're not huge. If you have four-hook limas, then it will take you longer. But you can see that these are sizable as compared to the kernels of corn. It will only take about 3 to 5 minutes to boil the corn once it starts boiling. So I'll put that on later. And when I come back, I'll have both of these vegetables done and ready to move on. I have my 12 ounces of frozen corn cooked. And I did cook it in 3/4 of a cup of water. I got the water to boiling and then I let it cook for 3 or 4 minutes. It didn't take long at all for it to be done. And then over here we have our baby lima beans, and I cooked them in 1 cup of water. And this was according to the package instructions, and I cooked them for approximately 15 minutes. Was a little shy of what the package said, but to me they looked done. And what I used to do is just keep a fork handy, and if you pierce that and it's tender, then you know to go ahead and take them up. What we're going to do at this point is combine them together, but they're going to go in this skillet over here. In this skillet, I already have melted 2 tablespoons of butter. You can see I cut off the 2 tablespoons from the end here. Normally I use 1/2 stick, which is 1/4 cup. But I'm trying to make this low calorie, and that's somewhere where we can cut corners without it really causing a problem. So I'm going to take my drained corn. You do need to get rid of all that water. The corn is going in here, and then we'll get our baby lima beans, which again must be drained. And we'll put them in the same skillet. And to this, we're going to add 1/4 cup of thinly sliced green onion. So you wash your onion and dry it, and then just take a knife and chop it into little slices like that. And that goes in here for flavor and also color. Now I'm going to be taking this back to the stove, but I want to tell you one additional thing that I normally do with this recipe. It makes it a little fancier. I use whipping cream. I use 1/2 cup. This is 1 cup's worth of heavy whipping cream, but you don't need that. So just leave that out if you're trying to watch what you eat in terms of the amount of fat, because this would be very fatty. But I will write it up so that you can do it either way. If you want to try it, then at this point, you would add 1/2 cup of whipping cream and then take this back to the stove. Since we did not add that, all we have to do is just get our onion up to the level of heat that we have for our lima beans and corn. And then we're going to season it, and I'll show you that in just a minute, and we'll serve it up. All I needed to do was to get the onion up to the level of heat that I had for the baby lima beans and also the sweet corn. So I'm finished here. I'm going to turn this off, bring it over to my workspace, And the seasoning that I spoke about is going to be seasoned salt. And this is just my shaker black pepper. So we'll just pepper it up a bit, just enough so you can see that there is a little pepper there. Don't overdo it. And then the seasoned salt, also a light hand on the seasoning salt, but definitely do put a little bit in. That looks good. So we're going to stir this around, and I think you'll like this more than you might imagine. If you're not a vegetable eater, this adds a lot of interest, and the contrast of flavors is just wonderful. In fact, it is so good that it is a traditional dish. It's not something that I just made up. It's been around for a long time and is commonly known as a very tasty dish. So if you eat a lot of this instead of maybe a lot of fatty or starchy foods, although this does have some starch to it, obviously, but there's a lot of good nutrition here as well. But if you eat a lot of this, you'll have less of a tendency to go back for a piece of pie or a piece of cake or something like that. So I'm going to serve it into a nice glass bowl. I really like to put colorful things in glass. That's up to you. And if you're just serving it for family, immediate family, sometimes it just doesn't really matter. But if you're having it for guests, you want it to look really pretty, and this will work for you and look gorgeous. Spilled a bean. And there we go.